We're going to be starting the new year with a month of prayer. We're going to be meeting on the first Wednesday in January by gathering at our new building in Somersworth. And then we're going to be alternating between Portsmouth and Somersworth for the whole month. And I really want to encourage our whole church to gather together, as many as can make it. But why? You know, John Wesley once said, God does nothing on earth save in answer to believing prayer. God does nothing on earth except in answer to believing prayer. Now, what if that's true? What if we could look back on our lives from the perspective of eternity? I wonder if we'd be saying, wow, you know, I really wish I'd spent more time praying. I think if we were to ask any of the great men and women of God throughout history, what, if anything, they would have done differently, I'm sure they'd all say, we would have prayed more, because they understood the importance and the power of prayer. And it's their testimony that still speaks to us today. Listen to D.L. Moody talking about going to be with Jesus. He said, next to the wonder of seeing my Saviour will be, I think, the wonder that I made so little use of the power of prayer. Elizabeth Elliot said, things happen which would not happen without prayer. Let's not forget that. What about Oswald Chambers? He said, prayer does not fit us for the greater work. Prayer is the greater work. The great Methodist Samuel Chadwick said, the one concern of the devil is to keep Christians from praying. He fears nothing from prayerless studies, prayerless work, and prayerless religion. He laughs at our toil, mocks at our wisdom, but trembles when we pray. Listen to Mother Teresa. She said, God shapes the world by prayer. The more praying there is in the world, the better the world will be, the mightier the forces against evil. And what about Andrew Murray? He encourages us not to limit what God might do. He says, beware in your prayers above everything else of limiting God, not only by unbelief, but by fancying that you know what he can do. Expect unexpected things, he says, above all that we could ask or think. Martin Luther, he said, I know whenever I've prayed earnestly that I've been amply heard and have obtained more than I prayed for. God indeed sometimes delayed, but at last he came. And of course, you can't really talk about prayer and not quote C.H. Spurgeon, can you? He said this. He said, it's well said that neglected prayer is the birthplace of all evil. Whoa. I mean, do we need any more motivation to pray than that? I like Corrie ten Boom's question. She said, is prayer your steering wheel or your spare tire? But I'll end with a voice from today, Beth Moore. She said, there are parts of our calling, works of the Holy Spirit, and defeats of the darkness that will come no other way than through furious, fervent, faith-filled, unceasing prayer. And that is why we've set aside January to gather as a church to pray. So please do join us on the first three Wednesdays and on the last Friday of the month. I'll see you there.